Hello, and welcome to the next episode. Well, next part. I can't exactly remember where I was when I last recorded this. This will make no sense, but yeah. Time for the play. I really hope that they didn't catch the light that we turn on. It's gonna be funny as fuck. It's just a little shadow of weed. Interesting how you can just walk into the back and no one gives a shit.
This day has been so messed up. At least I can talk to Rachel now. If I can find her back here.
SG.
Must be Steph. Sucks that she has to miss this. Chloe Price presents Firewalk Laser Light Spectacular.
No, I can't see it. You suck, game. Oh. Okay. Ooh, swords.
I've already seen what happens when Rachel plays with fire. Rachel plus swords should be fun.
Yeah, I think that'll end with murder. Hi, dude.
Drama teachers always seem so dramatic.
No shit. It's kind of the part of the job.
Sup, Mr. Keaton.
Why, if it isn't the muse of the Blackwell Drama Department.
How?
Tell me, young lady, do you still believe true love exists?
Yeah.
Sure, I think so. But it's a lot weirder and scarier than poets and pop songs make it out to be.
You might be surprised, my dear. Budding dramaturge. May your propitious appearance counteract the tragedy of Stephanie Gingrich's sudden recusal. An emergency, she says.
Yeah, someone fucking had their knee broken and beaten
Word.
To shit.
Stephanie was our lion of the light board, but platitudinal though it may be, the show must sojourn forth.
Or you could say go on.
That dude
fucking
is
everybody fucking
weird.
Fucking weirdo! Dramatic bitch.
After all the work Steph did, it's amazing that she would drop everything to be there for Mikey.
What the fuck?
Looks like Victoria has finally pushed Dana over the edge.
Did Doug dig David's garden, or did David dig Doug's?
Okay, she's gone insane.
Hey, Dana.
Did Doug dig David's garden, or did David dig Doug's? Did Doug dig
How
David's
garden,
garden,
or did David dig
Doug? Did Doug dig David's garden, or did
David? Oh, for fuck's sake. Oh. I thought I already saw that. Yeah, it doesn't deserve to be beaten to shit. Damon, you bitch. I have no idea what the fuck that Arcadia Bay like thing was meant to mean, or why someone got baking soda, aspirin, powdered milk, talcum powder, laundry detergent, and a plunger. Okay. Maybe he's making meth? I have no idea whether any of that is necessary for meth. Or drugs? I don't fucking know. Why would he have that? Why would you have that? What is this? Ugh. Alright. La 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 la. Oh, hello, dude. Hi, Hayden.
Even Hayden seems super into this play. What is happening?
Drama.
Hey, Hayden.
Address me as Ferdinand, good lady.
Go fuck yourself.
Alright. Hey, go fuck yourself.
Super lame, Chloe. I mean, super lame, fair maiden.
Jesus Christ.
Great, method acting.
Really? Thanks.
Dude, even I'm autistic and even I know that was fucking sarcastic. Ooh, what is this?
Bitter much?
I don't get bitter. I get even.
Wonder which Bachelor contestant Victoria stole that line from.
Yeah. Hi, Samantha.
That's some shameless eavesdropping there, Samantha.
Tell you what. Oh.
Hey, Samantha.
Shh.
Nathan, please.
I can't do it, Dad. I'm sorry.
Keep your voice down. Now listen to me.
Okay.
You don't understand. They all hate me. They're just gonna laugh at me.
Why do you suppose that is?
I don't know.
Because you show weakness. Just like you're doing right now.
But Dad...
When will you learn that this isn't about you and your problems? This is about the Prescott name. My name. You will not embarrass me. Nathan.
Fuck off.
Yes.
Good. Now. Break a leg. I'll see you after the show.
That is not gonna help at all.
Great pep talk, Mr. P. Everyone knows the best way to instill confidence in someone is by intimidating them.
I don't know who you are, the little but mind fire. Your own business.
I'd love to. Don't you have, like, a private bunker filled with gold coins where you could have these conversations?
Yeah. Go on, fuck off.
Nathan.
Fuck!
Thanks, Samantha.
Samantha seems pretty torn up about what happened between Nathan and his dad.
I want to talk to you.
Hey. Nathan's dad is some asshole, huh?
I know. I wish he'd just go away and leave him alone.
You should be careful.
Nathan's dad sucks. But you should be careful what you wish for when it comes to parents.
Oh, Chloe. I wasn't thinking...
Oh, I was just meaning careful of him.
I'm sorry.
For what? You didn't kill my dad. Or did you? That was a joke.
I know. Your dark sense of humor reminds me a lot of Nathan's. Actually, the two of you are really similar.
What the hell does that mean?
I'm serious. You're both artistic and surprisingly sensitive. You've been through a lot, and a lot of people unfairly judge you for it. I think you stood up for Nathan yesterday because you know what he's going through. Nathan's hurt, and he needs help.
No, because it was the right thing to do.
But whenever I try to help him, it always seems to make things worse. If you were Nathan right now, what would you want me to do?
Oh, I don't know if I would say help him, but, like, I don't want her to end up like Rachel. If I give him space, I'd give up.
When I'm super angry, I need to let it all out.
The last thing I want is someone trying to calm me down. Case in point, how pissed he was when we tried to help him yesterday. If I were you, I'd give him space and wait for him to come to you.
That actually makes sense. Thanks, Chloe.
Oh, I really hope it didn't fuck up and she gets hurt. Every other time, in the third episode,
I should find Rachel.
She's like in the hospital, or he's in the hospital. I can't remember which one. But I think he hurt her.
David's garden, or did David dig Doug's?
And I hope it didn't fuck up again.
Rachel?
Entry! Oh, wait, shit. Crude reflector, hypocrisy times. Okay, I got all the others. Stealth! Seems weird seeing her pink nail polish. I would imagine black or purple. Or, I don't know, blue? A darker color. Maybe deep red, not pink. Or maybe that's what they think nails are meant to be. They're very multicolored. Their ones. And they always have that little white bit at the bottom.
Whatever that was, it was shady as shit. I need to find whatever Victoria slipped into that drink.
What up, Frank? No, we didn't. Fuck off. No. I'm not letting you take his fucking money, because he's fucking...
Another letter to Max. That I'll never send. At least Journal Max won't abandon me the way real Max did.
Fuck, this is all the way at the beginning. Of this chapter, I mean. That, I believe that is fixing the car, then going to Frank's. And... time to dance. Hello. Anyway.
Only the finest child slave labor for Victoria Chase.
Yup. What's this?
I'm not leaving until I figure out what Victoria's up to.
Didn't even notice this.
I haven't seen this much spandex since Mom made me go to that Zumba class with her. Even though Steph's not here, her sticky still laid down the law.
Ah, things. Dragon.
Okay, this mask is actually pretty sweet. I hope Rachel gets to wear it.
I think she does. Can't remember though.
Hey kids, who wants to dress up like Big Bird's fugly cousin? I wouldn't be caught dead in this.
Well. note.
Adding putting on makeup to the long list of reasons I wouldn't be caught dead on stage.
Okay, that implies that she put those stickers there before she left. As in, like, before she found out this shit.
Oh, only fuck, the fuck. Finest child slave labor for Victoria Chase.
Just empty it, you fucking idiot.
Victoria Chase is actually a pretty talented photographer. Why does that piss me off so much?
Okay, why are they all like... Okay, first off, Nathan looks depressed as shit. like he doesn't even want to be in rugby. That's not bad. That's actually quite cute as well. Not bad. That's really good. Like, all these are really good. I don't like fucking Prescott. No, not Prescott. Wells. pills. Dun-dun-dun.
Muscle relaxers?
How the fuck would you know that? Soma. Carisoprodol. That's a fucking lot. 350 milligrams. Jesus.
Coming, Rachel. Hurry now before your tea gets.
Why are there lens flares?
What are you doing here?
Dude,
this
stop.
Area is for cast and crew only. Or are you only here to try and sabotage the play like you sabotaged my homework? God, you're pathetic.
I'm here for Rachel.
I'm here to support Rachel.
How nice.
Stop the lens flare. It's
I
not
want
necessary.
To make sure she's relaxed.
You can do like little ones
the show.
That are near it, but don't do giant to take over the whole fucking screen.
Oh, Rachel Amber. It was customary among the thespians of ancient Greece for the understudy to offer hot tea to the lead actress on opening night, as a way of showing appreciation for her tutelage. It is in that spirit that I offer you this beverage. May it help to reveal the essence of your talents for all to see.
Wow. That, thanks.
No, just fucking tell.
Wait up, Rachel. Bitch, dosed your tea.
Excuse me? How dare you?
Victoria, could this possibly be true?
Of course not. A dropout Chloe is clearly directing her misplaced anger at me. I'm sorry your life is a mess, but it's not my fault, okay?
Chloe, Victoria is my friend. She would never do anything to sabotage me.
Then she should drink the tea.
Then she should prove it. Drink the tea.
What?
I wouldn't dare insult Victoria's integrity like that. Then again, if that's what it'll take to convince you that Victoria is a good and caring person, fine. Come on, Vic. Put dropout Chloe in her place once and for all.
Okay, you barely drank that. Fucking drink the whole thing, bitch.
Happy?
So happy.
Whatever. If you're done accusing me of things, I'll just be on my way. Bitches.
Wow.
Saved my ass again, Price.
All in a day's work.
No problem.
And this has been a particularly batshit crazy day.
Sweet party. We're ruined.
Did she already collapse? Jesus. That was quick.
My dear young artists, a misfortune most unkind has befallen us. Juliet is waylaid. That infernal inferno is the culprit, closing down the roads and robbing us of our Ariel. Would that she could but manifest on her master's whim as a true spirit. Alas. Devoid of an understudy, the
situation.
I'm afraid we may
there.
Have to cancel. Truly, we are a cursed lot. Even my prodigious imagination cannot conceive of a worse turn of fate. Touche.
What?
No.
Oh, no.
Mr. Keaton,
no.
Chloe could step in for
no.
Juliet.
No fucking chance.
At least until the road's clear.
The romantic.
She's the right fit
not
for Juliet's costume.
How would
she
you
is
know?
Indeed. Tell me, my dear, have you
okay,
ever
please don't
acted
look at me.
Before?
Please don't look at
Hell
everybody like that creep.
No.
She's being modest. We play improv games all the time. And
different
she's fantastic
skill.
At it.
My dear, what if I told you that the entire fate of the production rests upon your slender shoulders?
Please don't touch me.
I'd say you're super fucked.
Chloe, please. For me.
And cut to that. okay.
I can't believe Rachel's talked me into this. I sure am happy to see you.
Why
right
is it already
now.
Smoked? Oh, it must have been the one that she was smoking earlier. But it already looked, it doesn't look like it didn't, like, they didn't even stub it.
The best part of being kicked out of school is never having to worry about getting kicked out of school. Poor Drew. He was just trying to keep his little brother safe, and there I was, stealing from him. That Damon Merrick guy was such a freak. It's hard to imagine Frank being mixed up with a guy like that. But then again, I guess I don't really know Frank all that well.
Is there more words?
I really hope Drew and Mikey are going to be okay.
Okay, I think that's it. And then she just destroys an entire fucking joint. Like, waste. Okay. I know I have to look at the script.
I seriously have to memorize all of this? Thanks, Rachel.
Okay, I'm just gonna... Oh! Take photos of my bitch. Things
Why does it feel like Steph is mocking me from afar?
Oh, that's new.
It wouldn't be called a makeup mirror if it wasn't supposed to have makeup all over it.
Wah-ha-ha. Nope. Do it.
When life gives you lipstick, use it to tag shit.
Death.
Got it. No, I am not just being dramatic.
Okay, I'm gonna...
The only thing worse than looking at spandex is being forced to wear it. Looks like I'm late. As usual.
Okay, so we're already got those on. I feel like those flashes are gonna be fucking annoying. And I wanna look up this way. Okay. Time for play. I'm gonna get my lines ready.
By accident, most strange. Bountiful fortune hath mine enemies brought to this shore.
Okay, I thought it was gonna be on her actual face.
Here, cease more questions. Thou art inclined to sleep. 'Tis a good dullness, and give it way. I know thou canst not choose. Come away, servant. Come.
Ah, shit. I'm on.
Oh, that's you.
I am ready now.
Get up there.
Approach, my Ariel. Come.
Damn it.
Okay.
No problem. I've got this. I just walk to Rachel and say my line. All hail, great mistress. I come to answer thy best pleasure.
Most fearless, generous spirit, hast thou performed to point the tempest that I bade thee?
I boarded the king's ship.
I boarded the king's ship! In every cabin, I flamed amazement. The fire and cracks of sulphurous roaring, the most mighty Neptune seemed to besiege and make his bold waves tremble.
My brave spirit, who was so firm, so constant, that this coil would not infect his reason?
Not a soul. The king's son,
Ferdinand,
was the first man that leaped from his ship and cried.
Hell is empty.
Cried, hell is empty, and all the devils are here.
Yes! But are they, Ariel, safe?
All right. I guess this is when I'm supposed to walk somewhere.
I go to the top of the shipwreck.
I want to play her part.
I'm just gonna look around.
Ugh! That killed my eyes!
Okay.
Well, that's pretty. I bet Steph designed it.
La 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 la.
Not a hair perished, and as thou badest me, I have dispersed them about the isle.
In troops.
In troops!
Bravo!
Fuck
Ariel, thy charge exactly is performed, but there's more work.
More toil?
Is there more toil? Let me remember thee what thou hast promised.
How now? What is't thou canst demand?
My liberty.
My liberty.
Indeed.
Thy liberty? Nay, this most of all I will not grant.
That's not her line, is it? What's going on?
But thou hast promised.
But thou assured my freedom, didn't thou?
I never said how dearly I hold thee. My habit's been to keep my soul well draped. Most loyal spirit, companion, and friend. Is acting in my service not replete with excitement, amusement, and delight?
Of course, mistress. Most truly, it is so.
Mr. Keat, they're way off script! It's magical.
Then why, I pray you, wish you to be free?
Excitement isn't happiness. Ooh. Simon will grow old. Simon will grow old.
Excitement ages quickly. And I fear if we set out in search of new fun, you'll tire of me. And then I'll be alone.
I have thee in my grasp. I will not bend. I will not see thee.
I'll run away. So come with me.
So come with me. Is that not in thy power?
Spirit, take my hands. Most faithful friend, for but a little longer I beseech. Continue in thy service to my schemes, and when they are complete, I swear to thee, we shall fly beyond this isle. The corners of the world are mere prologue. I'll seek to make thy happiness so great that e'en the name of liberty's forgot. What sayest thou to my most hopeful wish?
Say yes!
Yes, I am most pleased. Your duty done for now, so go forth hence with haste. I've work to do.
You crushed it. So good.
You had an extra,
thespian, my dear. I'll be chasing you down next year, and the ending, absolutely transformative. I am humbled.
Dude, just fucking
thanks.
Continue with the play.
What the hell just happened?
Compliment later.
Was that real? Put heaviness
in me. Shake it off. Come on. We'll visit Caliban, my slave.
'Tis a villain, sir. I do not love to look on.
He does make our fire, fetch in our wood. What ho! Slave! Caliban! Come forth,
come
I say!
On!
As wicked do as e'er my mother brushed.
Thou poisonous slave, got by the devil himself, filth as thou art. I have lodged thee in mine own cell, till thou didst seek to violate the honor of my child.
What?
Shit.
He's crying.
Fetch us in fuel, and be quick. So, slave, hence.
Fucking leave him alone, asshole.
Fuck you.
Where should this music be? In the air or the earth?
Oh, thank God.
This play is super intense.
Drama.
What is it? A spirit? It carries a brave form, but it is a spirit.
No, wench. It eats and sleeps and hath such senses as we have.
I will resist such entertainment.
Put thy sword up, traitor!
Do you love me?
O heaven, O earth, bear witness to this sound. I, beyond all limit of what else in the world, do love, prize, honor you.
His tears run down his beard like winter's drops from eaves of reeds.
Go release them.
And yet they
Ariel
didn't put the makeup on her.
My charms I'll break. Their senses I'll restore. And they shall be themselves. Now my charms are all overthrown. And what strength I have's mine own. Pray, release me from my bands. With the help of your good hands.
Come on.
Wasn't that fun?
You're so dead.
Yeah? How dead?
Hella dead.
Structural. Of course, she'd be there. For drama and intrigue! And so you don't know who, and since you don't know who she is yet.
Oh my god, Keaton's face behind you when you walked on stage? I was shitting myself. In the dead old night, I'll meet you in my sleep. He was shitting himself. Ooh. That dude owes me. In the morning light, you
wake up next to me. I love this bit. Like a dream come true, I'll take you where I roam. I'm really glad that they brought Steph back for the third game. And Steph got to date someone. Well, in my case, I'm probably going to play it for a few
minutes. What if I told you that the entire fate of our production rests upon your slender shoulders? I've never had an experience like that on stage. Yeah, right? You know, you. Like, seriously. I love nights after a show. Is it always like this? Oh, totally. It's such a high. No more nerves, just the adrenaline. So, first timer, are you proud of yourself? You were literally perfect tonight. I was blown away.
What? Sorry, I wasn't paying attention.
I think I'm just happy it's over. The last 12 hours have been freaking intense.
Yeah.
You've gone through so much shit today.
Right, yeah. Now's pretty good. Okay, the whole show was good. I admit it.
Yeah. It was magical. Let's leave. For real.
For real, huh?
You said you wanted to skip town and never look back. Like I said last night.
Don't even have a ride.
Let's do it.
For money.
I know. I've been thinking about that all day.
But that was...
Don't say it was just a crazy thought. You mean it. I can tell. You want this.
Yeah, but, like, eventually.
Let's go now. Didn't we already agree on stage?
We can't just...
Why not?
Money.
What about money?
I thought you were a high-rolling criminal now.
I gave the money away.
I collected the money Frank wanted, but... Then I gave it back to Drew instead.
It sounded like he needs it more.
Yeah. No shit. But man, I'm not looking forward to what Frank has to say when he finds out.
We'll figure it out, Chloe. Anyway, I've got more than enough to start us out. I always get birthday money from my dad.
Or should I say, hush money.
Any more questions?
How far could we possibly get without a car?
Yeah.
I thought you were fixing that truck in the junkyard.
I was just seeing if I could.
Well, can you or can't you?
Definitely.
Yeah. I can.
That's hot. In other words, we've got transportation covered.
But we can't exactly do it today. We need replacement parts. Because a lot of it's broken.
I know our parents have been shitty, but we can't just leave them.
That doesn't sound like Chloe Price.
Wouldn't it hurt your mom? She doesn't deserve that, right?
I don't deserve to live in the middle of my parents' mistakes.
Right.
Yeah.
Of course you don't.
Okay, you win.
Fine then, drama queen. Where are we going?
California!
You tell me! What uniquely twisted location does Chloe Price plus Rachel Amber equal?
Cali. Los Angeles.
Why don't you show me L.A.?
Perfect. Mm-hmm. 60 degrees every night, you and me on the Santa Monica Pier, gorging on food truck food, smoking up, looking at the moon shining on the waves. And a beautiful blonde man will sit next to us and smile at you.
Yeah, boo. Okay.
He'll say, I like your eyes. And I'll say, back off. She's with me.
You're full of shit. I love this time of night. Don't you just feel like everything's possible? Rachel, stop. If you don't mean this, it's just making me feel like shit that this life you're describing isn't going to happen.
For fuck's sake! I've never been more serious in my life. Chloe, what would it take to convince you?
Tattoo. Okay.
How about, Oh.
Yeah, you can feel it. Oh, sorry, that's so stupid.
Is that convincing enough?
Yeah.
I love them together. But I also love my girl.
Holy shit. Right?
Yeah.
What is this stuff?
Ash.
I think it's a sign. I think we should leave tonight.
Really?
If you want to, I'm ready. Let's go sneak some clothes and stuff from my house. And then we'll get the hell out of Arcadia Bay.
That sounds perfect.
James Umber, District of Attorney. What? Oh yeah, it's a fancy house. And it kind of looks like it's in The Sims. thank you for watching.